This video is about Dr. Catherine Pulaski,
and more specifically, her relationship to Commander Data.
After careful examination, I've outlined a short essay regarding her relationship with Data and the aspects of it that bother me.
I also think it would be helpful to compare it to the dynamic between Spock and Dr. McCoy from the original series.
In order to compare this, I need to first establish the dynamic between these two characters. The first clip is their first encounter in Season 2, Episode 1, The Child.
Data, look at this.
Data.
What?
My name. It is pronounced Data.
Oh?
You called me Data.
What's the difference?
One is my name. The other is not.
Is this possible? With all your neural nets, algorithms, and heuristics? Is there some combination that makes up a circuit for bruised feelings? Possible?
First of all, she's just not being very accepting. Like, she pronounces his name wrong, he corrects her, and she poses that he has a circuit for bruised feelings, and he actually looks really excited about that. Because he wants to be human, he wants to have emotions, and he saw that as her pointing out a human characteristic in him.
By 10,000. It does know how to do these things, doesn't it?
Commander Data knows precisely what he's doing.
Forgive me, Mr. Data. I am not accustomed to working with non-living devices that... Forgive me again. Your service record says that you are alive. I must accept that.
Now to compare this with the banter between Dr. McCoy and Spock from the original series. I'm comparing them because I think the dynamics parallel each other. The dynamic between Dr. McCoy and Spock can best be described in two main parts. The first one is Dr. McCoy exaggerating or pointing out physiological or emotional differences between himself and Spock to tease him.
Doesn't surprise me, Mr. Spock. I can't imagine a mirage ever disturbing those mathematically perfect brain waves of yours.
Thank you, Dr. McCoy.
Also, sometimes Kirk joins in the teasing.
I suspect you're becoming more and more human all the time.
Captain, I see no reason to stand here and be insulted.
Which McCoy always appreciates. But the reason this dynamic works is because Spock is very insecure about his human half, and so every time McCoy points out how different he is from the humans, he takes that as a reinforcement of his Vulcan identity.
Assuming you call that green stuff in your veins blood.
The readings are perfectly normal for me, Doctor, thank you. And as for my anatomy being different from yours, I am delighted.
So in the way they're portrayed, Spock and Data have a lot in common, but the reasons behind them are different. I feel very silly right now because I've been trying to articulate something that is very clearly expressed in an interaction between Spock and Data.
And Captain Picard has been a role model in my quest to be more human.
More human?
Yes, Ambassador.
Fascinating. You have an efficient intellect, superior physical skills, no emotional impediments. There are Vulcans who aspire all their lives to achieve what you've been given by design.
You are half human.
Yes.
Yet you have chosen a Vulcan way of life.
I have.
In effect, you have abandoned what I have sought all my life.
Before I bring the conversation back to Dr. Pulaski, I do want to point out that Diana Muldaur was in two separate episodes of Star Trek The Original Series. This picture out of context made me laugh a lot. This clip's from Episode 3, Season 2, and I think it's when Dr. Pulaski starts to be jokingly kind of mean to Data.
You're wasting your breath, Lieutenant. Saying that to Data is asking a computer not to compute.
Am I so different from you, Doctor? Are you able to cease thinking on command?
In medicine, I'm often faced with puzzles that I do not know the answer to.
She's right, Data. You always know the answer.
We humans learn more often from a failure or a mistake than we do from an easy success. But not you. You learn by rote. To you, all is memorization and recitation.
Well, I don't know about all that. Deductive reasoning is one of Data's strengths.
Yes, and Holmes, too. But Holmes understood the human soul, the dark flecks that drive us, that turn the innocent into the evil. That understanding is beyond Data.
Now you're just being unfair, Doctor.
I don't think so, Lieutenant. Your artificial friend doesn't have a prayer of solving a Holmes mystery that he hasn't read.
I have read them all.
You see?
Maybe the computer could create one in Holmes' style, one where you wouldn't know the outcome.
As I said, he wouldn't have a prayer.
The majority of Dr. Pulaski's teasing towards Data is focused on pointing out differences between his mind and a human mind, something that's already somewhat of a sore subject for him, but something that Spock would have taken pride in. McCoy's teasing of Spock is almost an inverse of Pulaski's teasing of Data. Quick editor's note, Pulaski is the main one who teases Data, but Dr. Crusher does sometimes kind of point out, like, hey, maybe you have emotions, such as in Identity Crisis.
I can see no other reasonable course of investigation available to us. We may not have much time.
You're worried about Geordi, aren't you?
I am an android. It is not possible for me
you to feel anxiety.
Starfleet personnel have vanished. Others may be at risk. We must do the best we can to find out why. However, I am strongly motivated to solve this mystery.
And in The Offspring, Data visits Dr. Crusher seeking parenting advice.
And be there to nurture her when she needs love and attention.
I can give her attention, Doctor. But I am incapable of giving her love.
Now, why do I find that so hard to believe?
Probably because the way Data is defining love as simple affection is not accurate. And I mean, well, it is accurate according to a dictionary definition of what love is. But I think what Dr. Crusher means by love and what Data means by love are two different things. Because any love between any people, it should encompass being there to support them. Wanting the best for them, even when it's difficult for you, and even when it's not what you want. Allow me to cite cinema therapy.
Love is selfless, love is kind, love is giving, love is sacrificing. Love is also about healthy boundaries. Love is also about respect. Love is also about being there for each other.
And so by that definition, Data should be fully capable of love. I just don't think anyone properly defined it for him. Now let's look at when McCoy is pointing out Spock's emotions.
There's just one thing, Mr. Spock. You can't tell me that when you first saw Jim alive, that you weren't on the verge of giving us an emotional scene that would have brought the house down.
Merely my quite logical relief that Starfleet had not lost the highly proficient captain.
Yes, Mr. Spock, I understand.
Thank you, Captain.
Of course, Mr. Spock. Your reaction was quite logical.
Thank you, Doctor.
In a pig's eye.
While clearly played for comedy, this interaction provides a useful comparison to Crusher and Pulaski's interactions with Data. Towards the end of season 2, Pulaski becomes more accepting of Data and teases him less.
And if they are not?
I hate to keep reminding you, but you are a machine. You'll be perfectly safe.
That is by no means certain, Doctor. But I was referring to you.
Medical research is sometimes a risky business.
I'm sorry I could not be more helpful, Doctor.
You did everything you could, Commander. As androids go, you're in a class by yourself.
But I think that the dynamic between Spock and McCoy can't be recreated with Data, because unlike Spock, Data is very childlike and he yearns to be human. And so it comes off as less of banter and more of her just being mean. I know what you're all thinking. This video could have been an email, and I've spent 10 minutes explaining something that could have been explained in about a minute. Thanks for listening to my unorganized ramblings about something that I care about.